I thought that he was sarcastic and unkind. So the director said, well, if you knew him, he isn't like that at all. But I didn't believe him. And we went off for a dinner, all three of us. Then the director eclipsed himself and I found myself with Serge. And I dragged him to the dance floor for a slow. And he walked on my feet. And I realised, actually, he was tremendously shy. And suddenly, scales fell from my eyes. I realised that all this sarcasm and all this rashness and the mauve shirt and all that was actually to hide someone who was devastatingly unsure of himself. And that made him terribly intriguing. And so then he whizzed me off to, I think it was first of all Rasputin, where he made all the musicians, on leaving that joint, play on the pavement Sibelius's Valse Triste. Da, 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 that one. And as we got into the taxi, then he shoved great notes of, I think they were 100 francs at the time, into the violin little hole, you know, behind the strings. And he said, they're prostitutes like me, c'est des putes comme moi. And then we got into the taxi and we went off to another nightclub where all the men were dressed up as ladies, to my amazement, and kissing Serge on the forehead and saying, oh, petit chouchou. And I realised that, of course, his father had been a nightclub musician, so they all knew his father, so they'd known him since he was tiny, and obviously thought that he was a darling. And on leaving that place, I'd seen more in one night. It must have been sort of 4 o'clock in the morning, I think, when I turned up at the Hilton Hotel with Serge, where the man behind the desk said, same room as usual, Mr. Gainsbourg. I thought, oh, no. Luckily, Serge fell to sleep immediately as we had drunk the night away. I didn't realise then that he was a poet. I think I'd called him Serge Bourguignon. He was jolly cross. And he gave me a little book of poetry in front of my mother. And that's when he asked me to sing Je t'aime non plus. So, of course, I said yes. And, of course, we bounded over to Marble Arch, which is where we recorded the thing. And yes, he wanted it an octave higher so I'd sound like a choir boy, which probably did give it something that was erotic in a strange way, maybe.